Welcome to La Mia Italy, a series of short videos about Italy by a Brit with Italian blood who's lived in Britain and Italy and loves them both. When you go to Italy, you'll see a funny brown drink on the supermarket shelves or in bars called chinotto. My nonna used to give it to me when I was a child and it tasted like cough medicine. However, now that I'm older and more aware of Italian coolness, I've decided that I do like it after all. Chinotto is both the name of the drink and the plant. A sort of citrus bush originally from China, which is a bit like bitter orange. It came to Italy in the 1500s and grew well along the Ligurian coast in northern Italy, and in the late 19th century was used for flavouring drinks. It's a bitter taste which seems to suit the Italian palate. Herbal liqueurs and aperitifs are popular in Italy, and some of these contain chinotto, such as Campari. Other examples which don't necessarily contain chinotto are drinks like Fernet Branca, Lucano, Ramazzotti, and my personal favourite, Vipero or Viper. They're commonly described as digestivi or digestives, and of course enjoyed for medical reasons after a big meal. I'm happy to be the guinea pig if anyone wants to find out if this is actually true. We don't really have these sorts of drinks in Britain, unless you count Jägermeister. Anyway, let's get back to the soft drink chinotto. It appears to have been invented in its current form in 1932 by San Pellegrino, the long-established Italian mineral water company, now owned sadly by Nestlé. It probably benefited from fascist hostility to foreign brands such as Coca-Cola, but it's unfair to describe it as Mussolini's Coca-Cola. But don't worry, I will provide you with a fascist soft drink before the end, so don't turn off just yet. Chinotto in the 1930s was apparently very bitter, but since the Second World War has become increasingly sugary and cough syrupy. Chinotto Neri was founded in 1949 and played a big role in promoting the drink's popularity, including with glamorous marketing and Sophia Loren, and its own Chinotto Neri football team, which played in Serie C in the 1950s. Red Bull are not the first drinks company to own a football team. Chinotto was also spread by the Italian diaspora, with Brio being a popular chinotto drink in Canada, which was founded by emigrants from Corleone in the 1950s. Martin Scorsese should do a film about them, just to show that not everyone from Corleone is a mafioso. I went to Malta recently and was struck by how similar their very popular soft drink, Kini, is to chinotto. It is in fact made from bitter orange rather than the chinotto fruit, but it's very similar in taste. I wouldn't be surprised if there is an Italian connection somewhere there too, as Malta has close links to Italy, which is geographically very near. There are plenty of references these days to chinotto growing in popularity again in Italy. I can't say I've really seen that much evidence of it, but I hope it's true, as chinotto deserves not to be forgotten, especially in such a globalised world where there's a real risk that all soft drinks look and taste the same everywhere. And finally, I don't want you to feel shortchanged. There is a famous soft drink with a much stronger connection to fascist dictatorships, Fanta. It was developed by Coca-Cola's bottler in Nazi Germany, when it was unable to obtain the magic Coca-Cola syrup, but could get hold of oranges instead. It's not entirely fair to Coca-Cola, who didn't directly have an association with Hitler or the Nazis, but it's good enough for now, and Coca-Cola did sponsor the 1936 Munich Olympics. I hope you found this video interesting. There'll be more to come along a similar line, so please feel free to subscribe. In the meantime, in bocca al lupo, and I'll see you all soon.